okay? And we're going over switches, okay? So make sure you pay attention, make sure we're focused, and we're ready to go to answer questions. All right, first things first. Let's re-go over this. Guys, when we're on the ice, okay, and especially when we do that 3-on-2 down low drill, what shape do we need to be in?
A triangle.
A triangle. Okay, so again, guys, if this guy has the puck in the corner, right, where is his support going to be and what does it depend on? Grayson.
Behind the net or behind him, supporting him for a cycle?
Nicholas. And what is it going to depend on? How are you going to know where?
The way he's facing.
Thank you, right? So, guys, if this guy's coming up the this way behind the net, where does the guy in front of the net need to go to? Aiden?
Behind the net.
Behind the net, right? And the guy who is along the boards, where does he need to go to now? Max? Colin?
Yes, head to the hash marks or the top of the hash marks.
Aiden?
Front of the net.
Front of the net. Right? That way, when all is said and done, we still have a triangle. Okay? If this guy is facing the other way and he's coming up this way, right? If he's down here more and he's coming up this way, where does our support need to be? Zakovic?
Behind the net.
Where does the support need to be, Grayson? What? Zakovic? Hash marks. Up here. Right? Where's the third guy? Grayson?
In front of the net.
If he continues to move towards the guy on the hash marks, where should the guy on the hash marks move to? Nikki? Dennis?
Where the guy
with the puck came from? Aiden? Front of the net. Where should the guy in front of the net move to? Grayson?
Behind the net.
And now what do we got?
Cycle
for a triangle. Yes? Right? You guys got to move in the right direction. If this guy comes all the way to the other side, right? Where does the guy in front of the net go?
Top of the...
JT? Wheels, where does the guy in front of the net go to?
Behind the net.
Zakovic, where does the guy behind front of the net go to?
The hash marks.
Thank you. Supporting here. Where does the guy from the hash marks go to? Jack?
Front of the net.
Front of the net. Right? You're moving to the open space. You're moving to support the guy. Okay, if the guy on the hash marks has the puck, where does another guy need to be? Zakovic?
In front of the net.
Okay. Where's another guy have to be, Zakovic?
Below the goal line.
Right. Zakovic, if the guy from the hash marks moves down with the puck, where should the guy with the puck in the without the puck in the corner go slower? Okay, that's an option. What's another option? Grayson?
He can switch with the other
guy. He can switch with the other guy, right? Now if he switches and this guy continues to go behind the net, where's the guy in front of the net gonna go? Aiden? Support over here. Where's the guy who switched with him gonna go? Steven?
Front of the net.
Guys, are we understanding the movement, right? It's just a rotating triangle, right? So I can't have one guy standing in front of the net the entire time. I can't have this guy not moving his feet. I can't have this guy standing still. If he's moving, this guy needs the support. Okay? If he's moving up, this guy needs to switch. Okay, if this guy has the puck and he's moving down, this guy needs support behind the net. Okay, you got to find the space and you got to support. Right? And it all depends on which way that guy's feet is facing. Right? So if this guy, right, is coming up along the boards, right, where does he need support now as he moves up to the hash marks? Zukovic?
Behind him.
Behind him, right? That way we can.
Cycle,
and the third guy is?
No.
Right, and then once that guy cycles Zukovic, where does he move to?
The front of the net.
Front of the net. The guy who is in front slides where?
Below the goal line.
Good, that way when this guy turns back around, what does he have?
Triangle,
option behind the net. Right? If he moves the puck to this guy and this guy comes up here, where does he need a guy to be? Dennis?
Behind him and in front of the net.
Behind him and in front of the net. Are we getting this, guys? All right, this is fundamental stuff we went over last week, 2 weeks ago, and fundamental stuff we went over last year, and fundamental stuff that you just need to understand, right? Moving with and without the puck to open space. Okay? So look, guys, when we work on the cycle, right? Again, pucks can't be bounced off the boards on the cycle. Right? It's got to get down the boards. So as we can see here, guys, right? We got guy cycling the puck, guy in front of the net, guy supporting behind. Okay? What else do we notice here, guys? Jack?
Carrying a triangle.
Triangle, good. What else? Nicholas?
Spread out.
They're spread out, right? This guy is not right on top of this guy, guys. Right, in a game, if this guy's not down here or here, okay, when we cycle the puck, we're not moving the puck anywhere. We want to cycle the puck all the way down so that we're creating space and getting the puck away from the defender. Right, again, cycle, right, this guy moves to the front of the net. This puck can't bounce off the boards like that. Got to be cycled all the way along the boards. Right, this guy supports, this guy moves to the front. Right? Now then you set up in your triangle and you attack the net. Okay, same thing over here, right? F1 picks up the puck. Look how much space is between the F3 and F2, right? This guy cannot be right on top of this guy, right? This guy's got to be out here, especially when we do this drill, guys, right? Don't just do the drill to do the drill. Do the drill to get better and simulate a game situation, right? You got to be spread out. Puck's got to cycle nice and low. And then when you attack the net, make sure you guys got a guy back door, guy going to the front end. Okay? Same thing on this side. Good spacing, right? This guy's supporting nice and low. And now we're getting all the way down. Are there any questions? Okay? So now in this video, right, we have a defender here. Okay? Defender's blue. Forward is red. All right? So now as this guy travels up the boards and this guy is attacking him, right, what are his two options? Oh, he's got a few options. What is one option? JT?
He can pass it up to the point.
Okay, good. Pass to the point. Option one. Good. Point's not open. What's the next option?
Cycle.
Cycle. So let's leave cycle as our last option. Pass from the point's not open. What's another option? Nikki?
Skating up the
boards. That's what he's doing. I want an option out of that.
Oh.
Steven?
You can turn the basket the other way.
Thank you, right? Turn towards the boards and escape?
Yeah.
Yes? Right? Why do we always want to turn towards the board, Steven?
If you turn the other way, you're basically giving him the puck.
Yep. So what are you using the boards as?
No one can get on the board, so you're using them as...
Perfect. What's another option?
Oh.
Who's sitting next to you, Colin?
Dennis.
Dennis.
You could cash it to the guy in front of the net.
He's going to pass through that guy.
What?
He's going to pass through the defender.
Probably
not. Okay. JT?
If there's another forward coming in at the top of the circle, so he can pass there.
Okay. Grayson?
You can give him a
lane
pass
into
the corner.
Okay. I want this guy to still have the puck. Zakovic? All right, so we can come around and attack the net from here, right? Mm-hmm. Now, if none of those options are available, what are we doing?
Cycling
it back down the boards. Okay, so now, as you guys can see, right, as this guy gets close to him, right, all his options are gone. He can't come to the middle. He doesn't want to turn back. And the point pass is gone, right? So all he's going to do is cycle the puck back down the boards. Guy in front of the net's going to come down low support. And now we create what? 2-on-1 and say it, time and space. Yes. And now again, right, we attack the net and we score, hopefully. All right. But again, guys, right, as the defender's coming on you, if you don't have any other options, cycle it so it gets away from the defender. If the defender's behind you, should we be cycling the puck?
No.
If the defender's back here, what are we going to do? Yep. Say it, Joey. Attack the net, right? We did this drill last year, right? The guy's behind you, you're attacking the net. If he's next to you like this, that's when you use your turns towards the boards or cycling it down low, right? But again, guy's next to you, right? So we're just going to cycle it down the boards, right? This guy's going to come towards the net, and we're going to attack. Yes? Right? One more thing, right? He comes down low, sees he's next to him, right? And now here's one, right? Where what? He's a little bit behind him, so what does he do? He attacks the net. Yes, we see that? Right, so depending on the situation, guys, right? It's not always a cycle, right? He has the space here, so he's going to attack the net. That's a fine play, too. So do we understand when to and when to not use the cycle? Yes? Okay, one other thing, and I explained this to John before. Right, guys, when you cycle this puck down low, right, do we want to continue up into the defender? John, what do we want to do?
Come back.
Turn towards the boards and come back this way, right?
Yeah.
All right. Or if the space is there, continue and make a play. But if this defender, right, if you cycle the puck down past this defender and this defender stays where he is, right, we want to make sure we're turning back the other way. If this defender continues with the forward that cycled the puck, that's when you guys want to come up this way. Does that make sense to everyone? Yes. So we don't want to skate into the defender if he's still there. Right, if he's not there, that's when you can come up the boards. Got it? All right. No questions about the cycle.
No.
We're good on the cycle. Are we sure? Yeah. We're going to move into spaces and moving into triangles. Right? Not just standing in place, but moving to support. Yes? We good with that?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. So now, right, we're going to add a new thing. Right? So really, a new thing we're going to learn, right? We kind of talked about it a little bit last year, but not really went over it at all. Okay, the switch. Okay, so what's the, so what do we cycle for? What is the cycle? What do we cycle for? Nicholas?
We're just going to like switching places.
Why do we cycle though?
To create space.
Okay, why do we cycle?
Oh.
Jay?
To reset the play.
To reset the play, right? Cycle is last resort, reset the play. And then create space and time out of the cycle, but it's resetting the play, right? Okay, the switch. Okay, the switch, guys, for guys who play basketball, it's like a pick and roll. For guys who don't play basketball, all it really is a drop pass or a non-drop pass, okay? And guys are just coming at each other and switching places, okay? And it can happen at any space in the offensive zone. Okay, so let's give us an example here, right? We got forward one, okay? We got forward two, okay? Let's say forward two has the puck. Green guy has the puck. Okay. As he skates up the boards, right? What is red guy's options? Give me the option we talked about before. Where would red guy initially move? Zukovic?
To the front of the net.
To the front of the net, right? And then front of the net guy will move to where?
To the corner guy.
Jay?
Hash marks. Behind the net.
Behind the net, right? So now, right, this is one version of our triangle, right? Now we can cycle out of this. The guy could turn towards the boards, make a pass, whatever it may be. Right? So those are our old options, right? Still an option. Okay, let's add a new option though, right? Say green guy moves up the boards. What can red guy do? Grayson?
He can move to the middle and give him an option to the
middle. Okay. What are we talking about though right now? Okay, so how would he switch? Yep. You're... Yep. Yeah. Right. So now, right, so the switch guys happens here. The red guy is going to slide down as the green guy slides up. What is this creating? Max, what is this creating?
Space.
Okay, what else? Nicholas?
More options.
Okay.
What goes with space, guys?
Time.
Okay, what else is it creating? Starts with a C.
Oh.
Steven?
Confusion?
Thank you, right? It's creating confusion amongst the defenders. Okay? Right? So now, right? If the blue guy's the defender, right? He's going to follow this guy, right? If you guys make that drop pass, right, what are we hoping the blue guys continues to do? Zukovic?
Keep on following the green guy.
Perfect, right? And then it's going to create space for this red guy to come in and attack the net. Okay? What else can we do instead of drop passing it?
You can fake the drop pass.
Fake the drop pass, right? So now we create the switch, right? But this guy will hang on to the puck and attack the net. Right? Yes? All right? Important. Okay. So right now we have, that's our switch down low in the corner, right? Where else can we do a switch? Steven?
Can you do a switch in the neutral zone?
I don't recommend it. Okay, behind the net. Alright? So, alright, if we switch behind the net, guys, right? Red guy comes, right? What's blue guy gonna do? Nicholas?
He's gonna come the other way.
Right, he's gonna come the other way behind him. Why is that important, Nicholas?
So the defenseman comes behind the net, he'll get the red guy first.
There you go, right? That's the pick part of it, right? Just like when we talk about being on the right side of our drop passes, the guy dropping the puck. Should he be closer to the defender or not closer to the defender?
Not
closer. Who says closer to the defender?
The guy dropping
the puck. Closer to the defender or not closer to the defender? Who says closer? Who says not closer? Okay, good. Right? So that guy wants to be here, so when he steps up, he's stepping up into the guy who had already dropped the puck. Or not dropped the puck, right, but creating confusion. Right? So we can make a switch behind the net, right? This guy can make the drop pass. This guy can walk out. This guy can move back door. And now we have a shot back door, right? Yes? We good with that? All right, so we have a switch in the corner. Switch behind the net, right? Let's say this guy decides, I'm going to continue to keep the puck. Now this guy can slide back door and we can move it there. We good so far? On the switch? Where else can we make a switch? Who else can make a switch? Ryan, hand up. I like it.
Can you make a switch
Okay. Where else though? Give me different positions. Dennis? Offensive zone thing. This is an offensive zone thing. He has a cover.
The defenseman at the blue line.
Thank you. Good. Right? So now, guys, right? Sometimes in a game, right? JT, where are you?
What?
You're famous for this. Okay. Right? JT gets his feet moving. He's buzzing. He's buzzing. Buzzing. He comes all the way up to his defenseman. Right? Happens.
What?
Yeah. Okay. And what does our defenseman do? Just watches JT go all the way back around to the other side. Okay. Right? What can we do out of this now, guys, though? Now that we're learning this. Joey? He could switch. Right? So as JT slides up, defenseman slides down. Right? So now, right? Let's say JT makes the drop pass to the defender. JT, what do you have to become now? What do you have to fill? Yeah, right? You are now, while that defenseman slides low, you are holding his place, right?
Yeah.
Okay, we get that? Now, defenseman, right? You can walk down. Now you're part of the offense. That's what we guys want you guys to do a little bit more this year. Okay, now you can make a play. Are you going to hang out there all day?
No.
No, you're going to make a play and then get back up top, right? Or score and then get to the bench, okay? Now let's say JT doesn't make the pass, right? What by making that switch, what are we creating? Starts with a C.
Confusion.
Confusion. So now it's going to allow JT space to come back in here and shoot. Okay? Let's say JT makes the drop pass. Defenseman, what's another option instead of just coming down low? What can you do? Brian?
You could come across.
Oh, to the middle?
Yeah.
Okay. What else can you do? Wheels? He did make the drop pass. What's he gonna do after that?
He's gonna cut to the middle to get a better shot.
JT can go to the top of the circles and the defenseman can pass it to him in the middle.
Perfect, right? So now we make the drop pass, and now the defenseman gives it right back to JT in space. Or, right, JT doesn't make the drop pass. Now what could JT do? Grayson?
He could go cut to the middle and shoot.
JT can hit the defenseman down low.
Hit the defenseman on the boards. Now what do we have, guys? Starts with an O.
Oh.
Options. We have a bunch of options. On one little play, we have like 7 different options. Different passes. Coming down low. Creating confusion, creating time and space for ourselves. Right? Defense is now joining the play. All right, so let's watch some video of what this is going to look like. All right, first we're just going to go over the one behind the net, right? Pass, guys switch, right? Comes back door, score, right? These guys are passing. It can be a pass. It can be a drop pass. But the most important part of the switch, guys, is what happening here. What's important here? Someone else. Dennis. What is happening here that they're doing a good job of? Okay, yes. But more specifically for the switch. Nikki?
The guy with the puck is not in front of the other guy.
There you go, right? He's behind him, right? He's closer to the net for the one behind the net. Do we see that?
Mm-hmm.
Right? We're switching. Now he comes back door. We attack. We shoot. Okay, we see that? Right? Again, right? Guys on the right side, you come back, shoot, and score. Now, right, we could come out a little bit higher. Yes? Now that guy pops out high and creates a better scoring chance. But again, every time, guys, the guy without getting the puck is always coming behind. Are we clear on the one behind the net? Right? And guys, this is basically the same thing you're going to do in the corner as well. Yes? We good with that? Questions about what it's supposed to look like? What the movement's like? Okay, now let's watch this one at the point. Okay, right? So our guy over here is gonna get the puck. Okay, he's gonna move, right? Now the point man had started with the puck, right? So can a defenseman initiate a switch?
Yes.
Yes, absolutely, right? This guy at the point has the puck, right? So instead of just throwing it at the guy, right, we're going to initiate a switch. Oh, wrong button. He's going to initiate a switch here with this guy, right? And watch what it creates, right? Little drop pass, right? We actually did what there?
Tripping space.
What happened there, guys? Watch carefully.
Do a triple switch.
You guys did two switches, right? We had a double switch, right? Yeah. The first switch, right? First switch, we make the drop pass, right? Second switch, right? Now this guy saw the first switch, so what's he going to think is going to happen again?
He
sees this guy coming, so he thinks, I'm going to go to this guy because they're going to drop it again, right? Now this time he holds on to the puck, right? Little quick, right? Do we see, what did we see there too, guys? Little thing.
He faked.
Little fake. He gave a little fake with the drop pass, created space for himself, and now we score, right? So look, on that play, right, it's two switches, but we create space for ourselves by creating confusion, right? Let's watch it one more time, right? Full speed, right? Guy moves, okay? Now, guys, this isn't a penalty power play either. This is what happens when you move without the puck, right? You got the defending team just standing still, right? Switch one, fake, switch two, right? We attack and score, okay? Very simple. Now, here's another switch, okay? Right, initial shot, right? Here he comes, right? Now he's coming along the boards. Yes? Right? That guy moves to the front of the net. Right? So the guy along the boards, right? We talked about that before, right? Guy along the boards, if this guy comes up the front, what should he do? Or what can he do? Move to the front. Right? But what did that create as that guy moved to the front?
Space.
Space where?
The top boards.
Along the boards. There we go. Good. Right? We create space along the boards. Now we switch with our defenseman. Right? What does this guy have to do, though? That's crucial. Once he makes that drop pass. So important.
He has to go back.
What? Yes, yeah, Ryan, you're right.
He has to go back.
Right, and cover for his?
Defenseman.
Right, he's covering for his defenseman because now his defenseman's down here. Okay? Right? Now we attack. Okay, make a nice play and we score.
Whoa.
Okay, so do we see that switch? Right, so this switch, a lot's happening, guys. Right? Again, this guy comes up the boards. This guy moves to the middle. Right? This guy recognizes and comes down. Right? So you see how everything is building off of each other, guys? Yes? It's all important and it's building off of each other. Yep.
Yes.
Okay. Wait.